Hi everyone. First of all, I would like to thank Lucas Winkler, who really helped me a lot understanding the concept behind heat maps. In this video, it's going to be very basic, so I'm not going to go into depth into what heat maps are. I'm just going to give you basic examples. So first of all, I'm using a library that you can find on patrickweed.at, which is heatmap.js, which allows you to create heatmap easily. So the word easy is kind of difficult to understand, because if you just copy and paste those given line of code, you will see that it's not going to be sufficient in order to create your heatmap. So in fact, you have a lot of examples given within the following website. So you will see that when you start to make your own heat map, you need to add additional things such as canvas in order for your heat maps to work properly. So let's first explain you how you can install this heatmap.js thing. So when you dig a little bit within the website, you will see that you will land on GitHub. So, oops, I need to go over here back, and then if you go probably at the bottom, contact me FAQ maybe, you will get the repository on GitHub. Okay, so you go here on GitHub and you download the full thing that you can see down below. And then in order to make this heatmap working, what you need is to read the README file. So, yeps, that's the one. So you need to install, you need to have Bower, then you need to fire this given line of code, then you need to enter within your project and you need to fire this line. Once it's done, what you need to do is that you need to fire the Python server. And when you fire your Python server, you will see that your terminal will tell you, so I don't know if I can, okay, will tell you that it's going to listen on a port which is the one 10337. So okay, so something like this. You will execute this line of code and it will tell you, okay, now I install for you a local server, and thanks to this local server you can start to play with the heatmap. So then you need to have a local page. In my case, I created the local page, which is the following one that I named heatmap. As you can see, it's very standard, you don't have much things. So in order to make the heatmap working, you need to make a call to the script of the heatmap, which have been downloaded through GitHub. Then what you need to have is that you need to have this given part over here, the div and the canvas, because that's going to be the place on which you're going to set to the heatmap where you want the dot to be plot. And here is the script for the heatmap. And here down below is the list of the different coordinates that you would like to plot on the page. Okay, so if you just copy, and so those examples, you find them back on the website. I mean, this script and this script, you find them on the website that I just to you, the one of heatmap.js. However, this part you don't find it, or at least I did not find it. So you will just need to copy and paste it in order to have a canvas of this side. Okay, so once it's done, if you just access to this given page, which is heatmap.html for me, you will end up with something like this. So as you can see, you have some different dots, and of course each of those dots correspond to the x and y coordinates at which the people clicked for me. So of course, if you change the value over here, and if you put like I don't know, like 288, and you change so the value is the size of the color, I mean it's the color of the dot. So here, if I go back over here, you see that this given dot's gonna appear a little bit bigger. Okay, so now the next big thing for analysts is to understand, how can I get the x and y coordinates? So x and y coordinates are directly given from your browser thanks to JavaScript events, which are the following one: var x event clicks, and var y event client y. We can grab those thanks to analytic solutions such as Matomo Analytics. So that's what I'm going to show you right now. So if I go on my if I go over here within my my tag manager, for example, what I can technically do is this. I can go over here and I can decide to create a tag. Okay, so it's going to be a tag which is called, in my case, is called x and y. So I just copy and paste the line of code that I just show you. So where x corresponds to the x coordinate when people is going to click, so it's event.clientx, where y event client y, and then I can push all those information as an event, so track event x and y, and then as a final value in the event, I can just call the coordinates for heatmap. As a result, what's going to happen is this. So if I go back on my personal website, for example, I'm going to make some clicks. For example, I'm going to do one over here. I'm going to do one over here. I'm going to four click over here. So what's going to happen now is if I go back on my webs, if I go back on, sorry for that, if I go back on my dashboard, I should see some new events which have been called. So if I look like this for the day of today, I will see that I'm getting those additional coordinates. You see those given coordinates. So I can in fact extract those last four coordinates. So I can just copy them. I'm gonna go back. I'm gonna go back over here. Just gonna change that out just to show you that it works. So let's see. So of course, on descent, heatmap, and clickmap stuff, all those are automated. Okay, so you don't need to take care of those, but just for you to show that it works. Okay, and so. Okay, that's the one. Then I'm gonna change this one, and so we say it's 1751 and 3395. And last one is 1777 and 529. Okay, so great. So now what I can do is I can save this. And if I go back on my heatmap, yep, as you can see, I get those clicks that I was doing on the right. And if I would like to know how it will look like if I had my, website on it, what I just did is I can create like an image that I will put as a background. So in my case, I just put an image that I just did, which is the which is a screenshot of my page, and as a result, I'm getting in fact the x and y coordinate at which people clicked on. So of course, what I'm showing you is not like 100% perfect. That's not something that you can really implement on websites. It's just giving you the basic concept behind click maps, heat maps. But I really hope that it has been understandable enough in order to understand the concept behind. Thanks for watching.